Well, good morning, friends. This is Terry from my cottage up north. I know it's been a while since I put up a video, but life got in the way. I had to spend quite a bit of time down in Green Bay, so I wasn't up here at the cottage much. But plus, once I got up here, then we had 3 days of rain, so there wasn't much I could do outside. But today, we need to buck up a few logs that I cut up. And we'll see what else I'm going to do for the day. I might take a couple more of the dead ones down, but we'll see. Tomorrow is the big day. Tomorrow I'm supposed to get my new shed. If you've been following that, you know I've been working on getting a ready-made shed brought in and dropped on my pad. So that's supposed to happen tomorrow. So I'll probably be setting up cameras tomorrow to videotape that coming in. And hopefully I can get that up for you. Other than that, my plans up here, I'm probably going to be up here almost to the end of the month. It's about the middle of August right now, so another couple weeks. And we're going to probably do some metal detecting and some prospecting. I'm supposed to go on an outing next Saturday. If we don't get rained out, I'll probably take some cameras along for that. But you just got to play it day by day. Right now, we're going to get these logs bucked up. And I won't split any. Well, at least I don't plan on splitting any right now, because the wife likes to do it when she comes up. So we'll see what happens with that. If I get the urge to split some, I might split some. But this is what we got today. This is what we got today. We just got three logs. This is all from one tree, but it's pretty rotten. I think it's only going to be wood for the fire pit mostly. But we'll see what happens when we get cutting. Okay, I got to get suited up and we'll just turn you back on. Yeah.
Oh.
There, I got those all cut up. As you can see, they're pretty rotten. That's why I figured they'd probably be okay for the fire pit, but that's about all. Some there, and then there's a couple over there. They're pretty well rotted. This is my little Echo chainsaw that I used. Some people say, well, how do you like it? Well, I would tell them that if it ever died on me and I couldn't get it running again, I'd go out and buy another one in a second. So, it's a CS330T, a trimming saw. It is the best little saw I've ever owned. And at my age, I don't need it. I've got a bigger saw. I bought a steel last year for big trees. But for trees of this size, if I can get the bar through it, I cut them up with this. It's so much easier on my back, which if you've been following the channel, know that I have a kind of pretty bad back. So it's so much easier on my back, and it's so much easier to handle, especially if I'm doing any limbing. But, you know, these are fair size. Saw's got a 14-inch bar on it. And you can see, you're running around 10 inches or so. Maybe this one's a little more. Yeah, this one's about 11 inches, 10 and a half. And I use it. Everything you see here was cut with this small saw. Some of these are fair size. That one's about 12 inches. So, yeah, like I said, if I can get the bar all the way across it, I cut it with this saw. It's so much easier on me. But that's it for now. Gotta put everything away. And then I don't know what I'm going to get into this afternoon. It's getting almost lunchtime now, so I'm going to be going to lunch. Or making a lunch. Yeah, I'm glad I got these cleaned up. Now I have room for when I drop some more. And I got a lot more to drop, so. I'm still cleaning up from that storm yet. This is the one that was in my front yard. I had a few videos back where I took it down. Cut it up. So. I'm happy with it. Everybody out there, you have a great day. Don't work too hard if you don't have to. And this is Terry at my cottage up north. We'll see you on the next one. Bye now.